Howdy, folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Xanadu. Today... Alright, I'm just making sure I have an inventory full of crap so we don't have to shop. Today, we are going to start climbing up the world tree in earnest. So we were kind of on the right path on where we have to go. There are two buildings, I can't remember where, along the path to the tower that we just got, well, I don't want to say kicked out of, but there are two buildings in the tower that we just got the onyx in, and apparently one of those buildings has what we need in it. We need the onyx to get a thing, and then once we have the thing, we can proceed apace to the higher portions of the world tree, and we'll be out of this purple fog area and back into our comfortable, buttery environs. However, first we have to get there. This is probably, if I had to guess, taking the long way. I might actually need to use my wing boots, not because I need to use them, but to clear inventory space, actually, because I think we are going to be given a key, if I had to guess. My god, calamari! Why gonna be such a pain in the ass? Okay, and I think we're still casting... Yes, we are still casting thunder. Fireball's nice and all, but thunder is better. Alright, so here's where we want to be. These stupid shits? No! I have touched poison, though that was unintentional. But I want to say it's this guy? As long as there are crazed dwarfs, the deadly threat of the meteorite will loom over the elves. Use this key to open the next door to get to Conflate. Alright. Fight for the elves. And we got a key of aces. Which... It looks like replaced one of our red potions. Which I'm actually kind of fucking salty about. I'm not gonna lie. And these motherfuckers, they always walk away from you. So you gotta chase them down, the bastards. Oh, decidedly better music. And we've got hit points in the form of little ghosts. Come back down here, you little shit. Oh my god. I am being outwitted. There we go. I'm being outwitted by a small ghostly creature. So yeah, this is mostly harmless enemies, which I'm thankful for. We've got these stupid dodos and ghosts, so we're gonna go ahead and grind up for some health here. The ideal would be not having to use any more of my mana. But realistically, I'm a dumbass. And also, well, we're doing okay, I guess. Whatever. Oh, it oh no. Oh no. I think we can just come back in here and get another key. Please. Yes. Yes. Okay, so it's mostly just an inconvenience, but I'm also kind of fucking pissed. Oh, come on. Yes, yes. Key of aces. Taking my inventory. It irks me that you can't equip shit in there. You fiendish drummers. Those enemies, like, if you were to ask me what my first... If you were to mention this game and be like, hey, Gene, what's the first thing you remember about Xanadu? Those enemies would be the first thing that pops into my head. They're just freaking nightmares. Much like these damn dodos and garbage ghosts. Alright, we're good on health. I'm not gonna farm this. I'm lazy. Alright, so we got some of these mace dudes, but the ceiling is low enough that their jumping does nothing for them. So it's a much more reasonable encounter. I just want to get to the next town. I don't know how far along it is here. Oh, that's trouble. What do? You just, like, sit there and... Alright, you just sit there and look constipated. Alright. Ugh. No, no, no. These things remind me. Oh, man. Here's a reach. Oh. Alright, apparently there was ointment over there. Those things remind me of... Oh, from the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Nintendo game. I think it was Rocksteady. When you fight him, he has like a jump attack like that. I might be wrong. I might just be thinking of, like, the generic foot soldiers. I probably am. But yeah, that reminds me of that for some reason. I have no idea. Hey, free healing, though. I'm sure this ointment is going to wear off at the most inopportune time. Okay, I want to say the town is to the right, and I don't... Is this poison? Yes, ointment. Is this poison? Yes. That's okay. Poison in a room full of healing. I'm not going to complain. And some calamari. This is the part of the game where navigating the world, I'm not going to say it becomes a pain in the ass, but you have a lot of options and it's easy to get lost. I think town is this way. Yeah, look at that. Aged memory. It works. I'm saving. Can we rank up? Probably not. Oh, no, we can. We are a Myrmidon. Okay. Where's the inn? I want to see if this is the town where we get a better sword. The giant sword, which is our next weapon, looks really dumb. I used to go to the town of dwarfs quite often when we had business with them. Okay. The town used to prosper from trading with the dwarfs. Sure thing, buddy. Sure thing. Let's see. Do you have one available? They're expensive. I think they're like 13,000 gold. Eh? Ooh, there it is. Giant blade. Only 8,500. Well, we have a goal. That is the second best weapon in the game. So that is our target. We are just a little under halfway there. And are otherwise pretty well set up, actually. Hey there, buddy. I am a guardian of the guru. He is an important person. Okay. The town is surrounded by dwarves for protection. Okay. Thanks, buddy. Get out of here, mouse cursor. Accidentally touching the touchpad on my PlayStation controller here. It's so weird. Like, I'm not used to it being there. Okay, so we can't actually leave to the right. And to the left, we got some magicians. God, I love this game's music so much. This is probably my favorite track in the entire game. This one right here. Okay, so we're in a pretty health plentiful area. Is that poison? Yeah, that poison is just gonna respawn, which is kind of a pain in the ass. Not because it damages me, but because we have to sit through this fucking text. Oh my god, it's horrible. It's a game, just let me take my poison damage and go. You need to be elsewhere so that I can kill your buddy and get your food. There we go. Okay, so depending on how crap my memory is, I seem to recall that our main goal in this portion of the game is to find the chunks of armor we need. We have to find the battle armor, we have to find there's a sword, and there's a helm. There is the mark of king by the keyhole. I think we have a second king? We have two king keys, alright. In we go. I want to say we're probably good to sell the key of queens. I do recall there being a fair amount of king doors in this area, though. Okay, we got these goony-looking suckers. You guys... I'm not even gonna... Oh, we can actually just walk straight through here. Oops, alright. Oh, hey, it's this fella again. Alright, so this guy, like, if you just stand here, you can see he's not actually gonna hurt you. And if you play your cards right, you can just wedge him in the corner and beat the ever-loving god out of him and he can't do anything. Whether or not I'm going to be able to do that, probably not. I'm gonna go ahead and pop a healing potion here. I think we might get the armor here. We can't equip, I don't think, any of them until, I think we need the sword? Actually, there we go. Like, that's the trick. It's like, you see how he, like, I hit him midair and he bounced back. You just gotta, there we go. Like, this is the trick right here. You just pin him in a corner and beat the ever-living snot out of him. Okay, so here's the helm. I've got the battle helmet. But if we come in here and try to equip it, it doesn't let us. Alas. So my temptation, I don't know how much money this guy's worth, is to just... Oh, he's not gonna respawn, I was gonna say. Is to just farm this stupid thing for money. Alright, I need you guys. Oh, I need you guys to not be where you are, basically. There you go. That's fine. Okay, and this one would be a pain. I think it's probably gonna jump, yeah. I was gonna say, this one would be a pain. Okay, we can just jump over. That would be a pain to get past. You wouldn't be able to do it without taking damage, I don't think. If it weren't for that little area you could walk through there. So this room, we're just gonna kind of pop in and out of. Get ourselves topped off healing-wise here. This is the point of the game where, like, consumables get very, very expensive. You saw in town that, like, potions and stuff aren't as cheap as they were before. Oh, and we need to leave. It's like, why am I not going right? That's right, there was a door. How novel. So we're gonna return back to town. And I'm going to save, because progress. But I would say... Alright, so what I want to do is do this, jump over it, touch the poison, spam A and B, and then pick it back up for some healing. Huzzah. I picked up copies... I've been, like, slowly rebuilding my Nintendo game collection since... Like, essentially, since I started playing this, I had a lot of Nintendo games when I was growing up, but me and my little brother were fucking idiots because we were kids. And we sold the grand majority of our names to GameStop. I know. Just cardinal sin. Believe me, I know. Anyways, I've been rebuilding it. This is the beginning of that. When I moved out here to be with my wife, she had a handful of games as well, so... Combined, our collection was like maybe, I don't know, 15 games, if that. When I was a kid, I probably had like close to 60. Most of them were really shitty, though, and I don't want to pick up a copy of... And I don't know, like, The Adventures of Dino Ricky or Mylon's Secret Castle. I don't care about those games. But I picked this back up because I really wanted to play it again. I also grabbed a copy of Phantom Fighter, which is like this side-scrolling kung fu game where you beat up zombies. Don't ask. It's pretty good. And at Jamalis' recommendation, I picked up Legacy of the Wizard, which I had actually never played before. And that game is mean. Like, that game is classic Nintendo. And I'm not sure if I'm gonna let's play it, but that seems like something that I would smash my face against in a stream pretty readily. So we might be taking a look at that one of these days. I don't know if I'll play it to completion. And if I do, I will probably be using a strategy guide of some sort. But... It's a pretty solid game. It is also based on the Dragon Slayer series. I want to say it's actually... Like, this was an offshoot of, I think, Dragon Slayer 2? Legacy of the Wizard is actually Dragon Slayer 4. So, like... It's interesting to play this and then play it and be like, wow, these games are kind of, like... In-universe the same, and it's fucking crazy. Oh, am I gonna need another King Key? I might have screwed myself here. Did we? No. Oh, I'm thankful for that. However, we are venturing far away from town. At the same time, though, money is good. And if I go back... I don't know where that... Alright, that fly is on it. Weird. So can I do that again? I was, like, just standing... on nothing. Whatever. This game. Fuck off, you damn dodos! Ugh. Bastards. They deal so much damage. I need to watch my health. Okay, here we go. There's the Mark of King by the keyhole. I don't know if we're near another town out here. But, I want to say that we're at a high enough rank. I love it that they just kill themselves. Suicide walk right off the edge. But we are at high enough rank now that... we should be able to pick up a free giant sword, which I would like to do, if at all possible, just to kind of save some money. Not that we really spend it on anything, but... Oh, I'm gonna heal. I'm gonna wuss out. Because I don't know where the next town is relative to our position. I'm gonna laugh if it's on, like, the next screen, and then I'm gonna be kind of salty. Alright, salt averted. Ah, yeah. I saw you assholes and your pixels flickering behind the terrain. Is there anything over here? There is. Oh. I would much rather have, like, a town so that I can wuss save. So these two jerks. So, like, these things, you can see their strategy is pretty simple. As long as they're, like, far away from you, they just kind of putter around all lazy-like. But as soon as they're near you, they rush you. Here, now, come over here. They have a jump, too. But it's mostly just kind of to be obnoxious. Alright. There. Fucking stab the shit out of you, guy. Alright. Ah, nothing. Ooh, this is the magic rod. Alright, this is actually, unlike the pendant, which says it gives you offense, but actually reduces it. This actually does improve your magic power. I totally forgot this was even here. We also have healing available to us, which is nice. Alright, where's that? I was gonna say, nope, I need to not. I need to be careful here. Okay, we can just leave and come back in. Let's go fight this fella. Gonna be a little bit harder to cheese this one. But I think we probably can. I call it cheesing, but it's not really exploiting. Well, I guess it is kind of exploiting game mechanics, but it's like a super simple pattern. Come on, guys, give me a break. And there we go. And there's the armor. The battle suit, which I do not believe we can equip. Alas, as I said, we need all three. We do have enough money for the giant sword. I do not recall how far off the sword is. Like, the final weapon sword, not just the... Right, you need to be, like, over here, buddy. There we go. Not just the giant blade. Okay, we're, I think, probably going to eat some damage here. If I can make this damn jump. God damn it. Yeah. Oh my god, it's game. Come on now. There we go. I think we're probably gonna eat some damage from this dwarf, unless I can just, like, do this. No. No, we have a stair-camping dwarf. Oh! Oh! Esports, guys! All we need to do is spam bullshit magic at them, and we can evade their trash strats. Alright, so I think we're gonna jump over here. And my goal is to lure this jumper over. Yeah, that guy can eat a bag of dicks. So we're gonna have this thing drop, and then I'm just gonna stab it into the pit. I don't even care about killing it. Oh, you shitter. Come on, then. Well, in that case, like, he's no threat. He can't get up to us. Oh! He's fucking... They look like turds! Like... Eh! Whoa! Hey there, buddy. That was kind of a bit of a surprise. Random wizard. Oh, there's something up top there. Behind that pillar. I don't know what it is. Probably a goodie of some sort. Damn it. Seriously? I bet you that's a town over to the right side. I know there's a wizard in here. I saw him spawn in. Oh, and I accidentally left. Although... If he's always just gonna spawn over there... Good money. Holy shit. Okay... Just another dwarf analog here. No real threat. Alright, buddy, you need to... Yeah, you need to just hang out over there. Do whatever... Oh my god. Get out of here, you stupid damn bird! Oh, thank Christ. I was mildly worried. Only mildly, mind you. Alright. We'll wait for the tavern lady to come back here. Have not seen you for a while. You'll find a magic cane when you get above the Tower of Pillar. Alright, well, we've already found the magic cane, I think. The Castle of Dartmoor is a complex maze. Thanks, buddy. You are of no help whatsoever. Man, I could have sworn. I'm sure this guy sells the giant blade too, and I'm sure it's gonna be like substantially more expensive. Alright, so tilt. Tilt is the best spell in the game. It is pretty beefy. It is a good magic. However, I think we're gonna hold off. We're gonna hold off on the giant blade. The Guru of Conflate has the Ring of Dwarves. We need that later. We'll get there eventually. Yes! Sell me your incredibly expensive and yet mysteriously restorative meat. Alright. I'm curious, I want to see how much the hospital costs at this point, if there even is one here. There is not. Alright, fair enough. So we're gonna pop in here, I'm gonna save, next time we will poke around in the house to our right and see what's up. But I'm gonna go ahead and call it. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching, hope y'all had a good time, and I'll see you all next time when the adventure continues. Until then.